When we're trying to understand the world around us, we often rely on data. At a basic level, data allows us to look at descriptive statistics about variables. We could look at a variable like this poll question. Do you approve or disapprove of the way Barack Obama is handling his job as president? A simple statistic might look at percent who said approve. That single number is what we call approval rating. Now, politicians care about that number because it allows them to assess change over time. However, someone might also care how approval varies by group. For instance, they might want to compare men's level of approval to that of women. This is where cross-tabulations come in handy. Cross-tabulations, cross-tabs for short, are also known as contingency tables. Cross-tabs rely on categorical data. Cross-tabs show how one variable differs based on another variable. And for that, my friends, we're lucky. Suppose we have a survey of 200 people. 100 people are men, and 100 people are women. We want to know how genders differ by how they perceive the president. A crosstab would provide a summary of the distributions of both variables. From this table, we can concentrate on four new numbers: the number of women who approve of the president, the number of women who disapprove of the president, the number of men who approve, and the number of men who disapprove. From these raw frequencies, we can calculate further valuable information. Let's focus on one additional step: within row relative frequencies, or row frequencies for short. We calculate row frequencies by dividing the number in a cell by the total for that cell's row. For instance, if 30 men approved out of 100 men total, that cell's row frequency would be 30%. Now we have a valuable number to put into a sentence. 30% of men approve of the way Barack Obama is handling his job as president. The same can be done for every cell within the table. Other valuable statistics derived from crosstabs include within column relative frequencies, expected frequencies, and Pearson's chi-squared test. Now the world is a complicated place. Fortunately, science helps us understand it. And now you understand one of scientists' very simple, yet very powerful tools: crosstabs.